How you doing? So we begin with change of subjects. I was saying that a formula comprises of two or more variables. Okay? For example, we had something like this, AX minus 5. We had something like this as our formula. Now, this variable that stands alone is called the dependent variable. And the others on the other side are called the independent variables. Why? This is because the value of this one depends on values of these other ones. That's why it's called dependent variable. The value depends on these ones' values. So, if I put 2 for A and maybe minus 1 for X, I'll get something like this. Y will be 2 times minus 1, then minus 5. So it's that same substitution that we are doing here. So we have minus 2 minus 5, which is minus 7 in our way of doing it. So this is to show you why the value of this depends on these other ones. If we change the values of A, maybe A becomes minus 1 and X becomes minus 3. It will become something like this. Y will be minus 1 times minus 3, then minus 5. Negative times negative, positive. 1 times 3, 3, minus 5. You have minus 2. You see, the value of y has changed again because the values of a and x changed. Even if it's only a that would change, the value of y will still change. So that's why it's called a dependent variable. And these ones are called the independent variables because they can change their values at will, but this one cannot. It depends on the values of these other ones to change. Okay, so in formulas, the variable that stands alone, the subject of a formula, is the variable which stands alone, which stands alone. So in that aspect, y is a subject. So in y equals ax minus 5, y is the subject. Y is the subject. So you get another name for an independent a dependent variable. It's called the subject. So we can, in a formula, in an equation, make another variable that is not the subject. To do that, to make variables the subject, to make another variable, variable subject, we apply the rules of solving equations. The rules of solving equations, which we did the other time. What are the rules? Making the required unknown, the required variable or unknown to stand alone. How do we do that? How do we do that? We solve like equations actually by removing all other variables or numbers from the side of the required variable. The variable we want to make the subject, we remove every other variable or number from that side where it is standing. We make it stay alone and become positive. Okay, so let's quickly go through how we can do that. First of all, subtract from both sides. Every variable or number which is positively, mind this word, added to the unknown, to the required variable. So I will stop using unknown here, required variable, because there may be more than one unknowns. So I will be using required variable here. Let me give an example. In y, okay, in this y equals ax minus 5, making a the subject. To make a the subject here, we know that there are things, there are other variables which are staying with A here. X is attached to it by multiplication, while negative 5 is attached to it by addition. Multiplication. While this is attached to it by addition. So, what we're saying is, if this were to be positive, okay, let's make it positive. If this were to be positive, we subtract it from both sides. So let's do it now. Subtracting 5 from both sides. We have done this before, just that we are trying to change subjects and we are doing this. So let's do that. Y equals y minus 5, because we are starting both sides, equals ax plus 5 minus 5. So y minus 5 becomes 5 minus 5 is 0. What is remaining ax? So we can still go further, but let's get to it first. The second point is adding. Adding to both sides. Every variable or number which is negatively, I know why I'm using this term, negatively added to the required variable. So we have, assuming we have the other one, y equals ax minus 5. Now, 5 is added to this, then it is negative. Because it's negative, we do the opposite. So, because it is negative, we add. Then we have y. When you add 5, you have this ax minus 5, then we add 5 minus 5 is 0. We have y plus 5 equals ax. So you see, 5 is out of that place. So the next thing we'll do is just to remove x, since we want to stand alone on that side. So So let's continue. We have 2 points already. Let's get to the third point. The third point will be dividing both sides by any variable or number which is attached to our variable. I will call that our variable by multiplication. So you see, we are doing the opposite, multiplication, dividing. If it is attached by multiplication, we divide. So from our two results, from the two results we had here, we will see. Okay, let's use the second one. When y plus 5 equals ax, and we are making a the subject, we can see that x is attached to a by multiplication, and to remove it, we do the opposite of that multiplication. We divide, dividing both sides by x, so that single and a will stand alone. So on dividing both sides, we have y plus 5 all over a, all over x, sorry, equals ax all over x. So here, x can now cancel x. We have 1, a times 1 is a. We have that a equals y plus 5 all over x, or y over x plus 5 over x. When x divides y, you have y over x, and divides 5, you have 5 over x. Any of these would be acceptable as an answer. So I believe we are making some progress. Then finally, or maybe not the last, but then specifically, multiplication of both sides by the variable or number which is dividing the required variable or the potential subject. We are trying to get terms that will suit what we are doing. So from here, y plus 5 equals a over x. Our potential subject is a, okay, our subject. So for x to for a to be alone here, x we have to go leave that particular area, and because it is divided, we multiply both sides. By x, because it's dividing. So here we have x times y plus 5 on one side, and then a over x times x on the other side. X will cancel x here too. You see, what we have here is a equals x into y plus 5. This is simpler than xy plus 5x. This is simpler than, you know what we did here? We opened the brackets. This is simpler than this. So when you are leaving your answers, unless the option is not, the answer is not in the option, then you go for this, which may be in the option. Okay, so I have tried to show you that in change of subjects, we are simply solving equations, but equations with letters. So in change of subject, in the change of subjects, We solve equations. We solve equations. But only with letters or variables. Mainly. The same thing, the same pattern of solving equations, that's what you apply in changing subjects. So those things you would do when you see roots, when you see powers, and so on and so forth. In equations, that's also, it will be the same things that you would do when you see them in change of subjects. So questions will all often come, make X the subject, okay? And derive a formula for X. These are ways of telling you to make X the subject. Let X stand alone in that equation. So I hope that makes a lot of sense. So we'll take a few examples and see where that leads us. Examples. In the equation, V equals U plus AT. Making A the subject. So you are, if I asked to make A the subject in this equation, V equals U plus AT. You identify A and then look at the other variables that you have to remove from that place. So let's solve. Solution. In V equals U plus AT, we are making A the subject. We want A to stand alone. First of all, we remove U. Because just like I told you the other time, U is only adding. So you remove everyone that is attached by addition or subtraction, because they are easier to remove than the other ones. So by removing this, we take note of the sign. It is positive, so we subtract. Subtracting U from both sides. We have, from where V is, you subtract U. From V, you subtract U. And from U plus AT, you subtract U. U will cancel minus U to give 0. So what we have here is V minus U equals AT. So we are still making A the subject. T is with A there by multiplication. So because T is multiplying, we divide both sides by T. Take note, dividing both sides, you're always doing the opposite of the operation you find there by T. So we have V minus U divided by T equals AT divided by T. The T here, we will remove the T here, cancel it and get one. A times one is A. Now that A equals V minus U over T, or V over T minus U over T. It is simpler than that. Here, ladies and gentlemen, we have made A the subject. A is the subject here now, but V was the subject here. So we have changed V from being the subject to A being the subject. So there is absolutely nothing. There's nothing difficult in this. There's nothing difficult in this. So we take another example. Let's take this. K equals 2A brackets They want us to making the subject. They want us to make the subject here. You see, there are many things here. First of all, we have a radical, a square root sign. This is a square root sign covering up C and minus D. And then we have 2a multiplying that whole radical and everything inside it. First of all, we will remove these ones here before we start opening up the radical. You see, solution. We have k equals 2a into c minus d. We want to make this subject, so we remove this 2a because it is multiplying, we divide. Because it is multiplying, we divide. Dividing both sides by 2a. So you have k over 2a equals 2a root c minus z over 2a. So 2a will cancel 2a, which gives 1. You have k over 2a equals root c minus d. Now, it doesn't present much of a problem because we already know to remove the root, we square. Because this is square root, meaning raised to power half. To remove the square root sign, we multiply that power by 2. That is squaring. So we square both sides. Squaring both sides, we have k over 2a. We square it. And then c minus d, we square it. Now the square will open up the square root sign. This comes out. So we have here k squared over 2 squared is 4, a squared is a squared, equals c minus d. We are making d the subject. Remember that. Making d the subject. So to make d the subject, we remove c. C is positive here. And to remove it, we subtract. Subtracting c from both sides, we have k squared over 4a squared minus c equals c minus d minus c. C minus c here is 0. What we have here is k squared over 4a squared minus c equals minus d. What we want to make the subject is d and not negative d. We have gotten negative d. Now, to remove the negative sign here, remember this means minus 1 times d. So there is still minus 1 hovering around d here and by multiplication. So we still divide or multiply. Here, I will multiply. Multiplying or dividing both sides. Any of them you do can go. Dividing both sides by negative 1. So you have 1 minus 1 multiplies everything here. K squared over 4a squared minus c. You get something then. Minus 1 times minus d. Both sides, remember that. Minus times, here is plus, times everything here, plus, minus, k squared over 4a squared. Minus times minus here is plus, here plus c. Plus minus times minus, plus 1 times d. So, in a nutshell, we have that d equals c minus k squared over 4a squared. Which we want to give you 4a squared c minus k squared over 4a squared. This is simpler than this. So always go with a simpler version of stuff, things. So I would like you to go through this again, and then go on your own. You can go online, go to your textbook, go to the change of subject, the topic change of subject, and make out time to solve problems there. I have given you the basics, even right from the time we did equations. I've given you the basics, which should help you. So we end this very topic here. The next topic you'll be seeing online will be, let me write it, with trigonometry. We try to treat everything concerning trigonometry. So go through what we have done, and then thank you so much. I'll be seeing you.